Hi, welcome to Eretec Solutions. This is one more application with microcontroller, speed control of DC motor using switches. So this concept you can apply for even sensors. So many people wants to know about the speed controlling techniques with motors. So here I am working with a DC motor. So you can work with even AC motors. The many industries are looking for these kind of applications. I am showing one prototype. So here I am using buttons. There are three individual buttons for different speeds. So along with microcontroller. So I will show you the block diagram of this application. So this is your block diagram of application, which contains power supply and microcontroller unit and switches and motor driver and motor. So I'll explain individual blocks. There is power supply, which is used for AC to DC conversion. So for AC to DC conversion, you need to use one bridge rectifier and filters and regulator. Bridge rectifier converts AC to pulsating DC, but this is not pure DC. So this pulsating DC, which is filtered through electrolytic capacitors, as per basic property of capacitor allows AC blocks DC. So this block DC passes through these regulators. Regulators provides constant output irrespective of any input. So this fixed constant output you need to use for entire application. And here I am using two terminal buttons to as an input for your microcontroller. And microcontroller is your 8051, which is 40 pin deep package microcontroller. And as motor driver, I am taking L293D. So this supports to drive the voltages from 5 volts to 24 volts DC supply up to 2 amps current. So, and I am connecting one DC motor with the driver IC outputs. So how I am controlling speed as per PWM technique? So most of you are aware of this word, pulse width modulation. So rather than giving constant output to the one end of motor, so I am changing my output pulse with different time intervals. So just managing your input pulse with on off, so you can control the speed of motors. If you are giving proper input with 50% due on time and 50% off time, it is considered as your 50% duty cycle. So here your motor will run with average speed, and whenever you are providing 75% duty cycle, which is more than average and less than max, so maybe 75% or 90% your motor will run with maximum speed. Whereas 25% duty cycle, here off time is more, on time is less. So this concept will help you to control the speeds of motors, even for industrial loads or even drives. So many speed drives units, they use this standard technique, pulse width modulation, for AC motors and as well as DC motors. So the same programming I am doing with delay, with high and low, with my programming logic. So I will show you the hardware connections with these buttons and driver IC and motor. So this is a circuit for your application. So there are three individual buttons, low, average and high. So these three buttons I am using for speed control, and one end of motor I am giving direct ground connection, and other end of motor I am using only one input channel from this driver IC. It's a 4 channel driver. So one input I am connecting with this P2.0. If you are giving direct high, it runs with maximum speed. So now as per previous discussion, whenever you are giving high low output, then the speed will vary from your motor. So three individual buttons I am using here. If I am pressing this low, it runs with very low speed, and if I am pressing this average button, it runs with medium speed, and if I am pressing high, it runs with 74% speed. If you are giving direct one, it runs with maximum speed. So this is your hardware connection. Let's one input I am connecting with motor driver IC, and three IO pins connections I am using for switches. So this is my circuit diagram for switches and motor driver and motor combination. So now I will show you the source code of this application, which is developed in Keil Microvision IDE. The Keil Microvision IDE, which supports to develop .hex files for your embedded C programs. Whereas Keil IDE, which supports for many manufacturers, this is one more popular IDE for all embedded developers. So everyone is aware of this. Writing program and compiling this program and creating executable, which means .hex file for this program. So this is your first line of your program, hash include register 51.h. So which allows to use all SFR registers from your microcontroller. And these are hardware connections, declarations. So motor 1 input I am connecting with P2.0 IO pin from the circuit. And three hardware connections of switches or buttons, low, average and high, I named as same. And one delay user defined function I am taking here to maintain high to low delay between high and low. And main logic starts from here. The motor initial logic is 0. And now I am entering into this infinite loop while of 1. The compilation is keep on checking these states of switches. If any button is operated from the hardware, then it enters into this condition. So let's see, initially for low button input, I am assigning my logic motor 1 as 1, and for high delay, I am giving very low time delay, but for low logic, I am giving more time delay, so that which allows to work with more off time and less on time, so that the switching should be different for your low button. The same logic whenever you are observing for average input, average button, then so logic is different than low. So here motor 1, which is delay of 50, and motor 0, delay of 50. So this is for 50% duty cycle for your motor. And whereas high logic, motor 1 is 1, this means more on time and less off time for your motor input logic. And delay function, just whatever the argument you are passing here, which is given to this temporary variable v1, and this is self for loop until it becomes 0, then you are keep on incrementing. So this is a simple logic behind the speed control of DC motor with microcontroller. I will show you the output with simulation. So this is my hardware connection, the speed control of DC motor. The Proteus, which is one of the most popular simulation tool, so even industries follows the same technique, they never approach hardware directly. So once you want to test your output of your application, first they will check outputs with simulation. Generally simulation will help to check hardware results with the help of software rather than approaching direct hardware. So these three buttons I just connected with P3.0, 3.1 and 3.2. Just take your proper components from this by clicking on this P symbol from library and do your hardware connections as VCC, ground and motor. And the other terminals of buttons you need to connect with ground. Now you need to link your hex file, which is developed in Keil Microvision IDE. This is my hex file. So don't link your .c files or .asm files. You need to link .hex file. And click on OK. Now play your... See, initially the response of motor is off. So whenever I'm operating button high, then it start running with maximum RPM. So let's see this RPM. which is more in the case of high button, which will reach up to 190 or 200. So this motor runs with high speed in the case of high button. But whenever I am releasing this button and trying to operate this average speed, then speed should be reduced here, which is coming less than 100. So now average button is closed and the speed is limited to below 100. Again, as a user, if you are operating button high, then your speed is keep on increasing. Become again, it will reach to 160. So again, you release your high button and close low, then your speed is reduced to very less compared to average and high button. So even you can watch this high to low input operation here, so that your speed is very limited in the case of low button input. Again, you are releasing your low button, and if you are operating high, then it starts keep on increasing the RPM. So like this, you can easily implement the speed control of your DC motors with simple PWM technique with your programming. So please subscribe our channel for more technical videos on microcontrollers. And please comment as your valuable feedback. Please like, share, and so just type your Aerotech Solutions from YouTube and subscribe this channel for more videos. And we will start doing good applications on microcontrollers with all different families, PIC, AVR, Arduino, and LPC2148 ARM series controllers. Please subscribe our channel. And if you have any training related requirements, please get back with this number 9676327118. We will give online and classroom trainings, and we will support for placement also with all different companies as per your technical skills. And we will do projects on different categories. So anyone wants to reach our office, please follow this address: Rajamma Towers, Jayanagar, Baginagar Colony, which is located to KPHP Metro Station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. If you have any queries, please write an email ysnanda@aerotechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.